How to start a YouTube channel, no fluff. Okay, you've thought about this, right? You thought about starting a YouTube channel. And you know, I did too about 5 years ago, and I started it and I failed at it. I didn't do well. Didn't do well at my YouTube channel. Why didn't I do well? Because I didn't do what I was supposed to do. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know how to make videos, what kind of videos. I didn't have no direction whatsoever. So I've made this video for you because when you watch this video to the end, you're going to have direction. You're going to know what to do. And if you follow these steps, you're going to be successful. Now, in the past 8-9 months, I followed the rules. I did what I was supposed to. And guess what? I got results. I got people viewing. I got comments. I got monetized. I'm making money. All because I followed some rules. So I'm going to give you those rules, and I think you're going to like them. And I think you're going to find it's not that hard to do. And we're starting right now. Now, you know something else that's not really hard to do. A lot of people don't do, but they should. They really should, and you should do it too. And that's hit the subscribe button below. If it's red, it's warning you. It's saying you need to hit me. And when you hit it and you smash it and you crush that subscribe button, a bell's going to pop up just like this. You won't see the bell till you subscribe. But when you do, you got to ring the bell, turn on all bell notifications so that you're notified every single time I do a video. I said that fast enough? I think I did. That way you don't miss a single video that I do and you won't have to come looking for it. You don't have to go scurrying around in the dark and middle of the night trying to find videos from me. Who wants to do that? No, you want to be notified. You want to be part of the Fisher family, the VIP group that gets notified every time I go live. Okay, so let's talk about YouTube. Okay, the first thing I'm going to tell you is when to start. Okay, you need to really analyze this, when to start. Here's when, lean in, let me tell you. Here's when you start. Now. Now, start right now. Okay, don't wait. No, no, not tomorrow. Right now, literally. Well, yeah, I mean, at the end of the video, but I mean, it's as soon as you finish this video, then you could start, okay? So surprisingly, a lot of people have thought about making a YouTube channel. They thought and they thought and they thought and they thought for days and they thought for weeks and they thought for months, they thought for years. I'm not talking about you, am I? Am I? I hope not. I hope that's not you. I hope this is the first video you watched on it. You're raring to go. It's like this, guys. YouTube is growing at such a fast pace. And that's what scares a lot of people. They go, am I too late to the party? You know, is it too late to start a YouTube channel? Most certainly not. Think about this. If it's really growing now, why is it growing? It's really growing because there's more users. There's more users than there were in 2004. Okay, a lot more users. Like, there's billions and billions of views. So it doesn't matter that there's more creators. It doesn't matter that there's more channels. Your audience is still a lot bigger per channel than it was years ago. Now's the time to start. And every day that you miss, every day that you wait is a day that you could be moving forward. And here's the thing with YouTube, it's funny. You know, I started off doing videos. I think I did my first one in 2015, and then I didn't do anything for a while, and I did some more. It was really haphazard. There was no way my channel could grow until I got serious about it, which I did, and now it's grown, and I'm gonna share that with you. But here's the point. Every time you press that record button, you're gonna get a little bit better. It may not seem like it, okay? It may seem like you're terrible on camera, you may hate it, but the point is, the more you do it, you're gonna get, if nothing else, a little bit more confident. You're gonna feel a little bit better about yourself. And if you keep doing that, you're gonna keep moving forward. And if you wait, it's another lost day. Don't do that. Even if the videos you shoot, let's say you shoot a video and you think it's horrible, you say, I cannot upload this, JR, I can't do it, then don't upload it. But at least you got that horrible one out of the way. Unfortunately, I uploaded the first horrible one. If you go back to the beginning of my channel, you'll see it. Please don't do that. Please don't go back to the beginning of my channel and look at that video. I don't want that to be the most watched video at all, okay? But you'll see what I mean. And this is not just true with my channel. It's true with just about any channel. You find some of the YouTubers that you really like, and you go to their videos, and then you sort by oldest video, and check that out. Look at that video. I really like Mark Weens. I follow his channel, but I went and checked out his original video.
It's a T. I'll give you a look at it right here, as you can see. And it has a real earthy smell to it. First of all, you need the device. You got here a little silver guy.
It was not the best video he had ever done, But you know what? Yours won't be either. You just got to get started. You got to get through the crappy videos. Now, maybe you're just going to be a star on film. And if that's the case, you really don't want to wait because you're that great, right? Number two, learn how YouTube works. No, seriously, learn how it works. Know the mechanics of it. Just because you've been watching YouTube for 5 or 10 years doesn't mean you know how YouTube works. The only way you're really going to know how YouTube works is by actually uploading videos, by editing videos, by putting in titles and descriptions. And here's the deal, and I didn't do it. If there's a spot for you to do something, that means you should do something, okay? I didn't always put descriptions on my videos. That's dumb. I didn't always put tags on my videos. That's really dumb because nobody can find your videos if they aren't tagged. How are they going to find it? How in the world is YouTube going to say, here's a video, if when somebody searches in the keywords, you don't have any keywords in your videos? That's dumb. Okay. But that's what I did in the beginning. So I'm telling you, learn how YouTube works. That will help you out more than anything else. Number three, develop a strategy that you will follow. Understand that the people watching your videos do not care if you get more subscribers. Now I'm going to ask you to subscribe, of course, but you don't care about that. That's not why you came to this video. You don't care how many likes I got or how many comments I got. You care about getting information that's going to be useful and helpful to you. So when you're doing your YouTube videos, think about how you can help the viewer, not how you can help yourself. Think about who your target audience is. Okay. I have an audience that wants to learn how to make money online and get better at it. So all the content I make has to do with helping them make more money online because that's what they want. I need to solve that problem for them and they'll keep coming back. If I switch and all of a sudden the next day I'm doing amusement park rides and then I'm going out to dinner and I'm talking about the best steak, they're not going to stick around because that's not why they subscribe to my channel. So, you know, you need to clear your head and say, who am I speaking to? What's my message and what am I trying to help people with? And of course you want to think about how you're going to deliver this content, you know, and this is super important. Something I didn't take into account is that people expect what they know. They expect what they know. In other words, if I were to publish a video every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, for 3 months, and then I didn't publish for a month and a half, and then I started doing Tuesdays and Thursdays, I'm going to lose my audience. Okay. Because that's what they expect. They expect what I'm doing. So whatever I do, I need to do what I'm doing, or I can always add to it. So, you know, right now I'm publishing 5 videos a week, Monday through Friday, you get a video from me. Okay. So if you subscribe, that's pretty cool, right? Hit the subscribe button. You get 5 videos a week. And I do a live on Saturday right now. Now that live can switch up. Sometimes I did them on Friday. I've switched it to Saturday. But the point is I do a lot of videos. I do 6 videos a week and I say it's a lot. It really isn't. You know, I know a guy that I follow Gunby Publishing and he can do 4 or 5 videos in a day. Yeah. 4 or 5 videos a day. That's a lot of videos. But the bottom line is they know what to expect. I publish them at the same time of day, so they know when it's going to come out too. Figure out when your audience is going to be online. You're going to have to get some views first to see that. But after a while, YouTube will actually tell you when your audience is online, so you know when to publish them. Number four, invest in the right audio equipment. Now, right now, I got this little mic right here and it goes down to my pocket and it goes to this transmitter. And right there on the camera, I've got a receiver for it. I do that because I want to have better audio. People don't listen. They don't listen to videos if the audio is bad. They will watch a video if the video is not that bad. But when you have bad audio, man, it really hurts. Now, this is not to say that you got to go out and buy an expensive microphone. What I'm saying to you is have good audio. My cell phone right here, which I have a timer going right now, you can see how long I've been talking on this video, has a really good microphone on it. If I'm about this far away, it has a pretty good microphone on it. But if I were to put it on a stand over there and it's on the stand that's about 5-6 feet from me right now, it would sound terrible because this microphone picks up everything in the room and any echoes off the walls, it's going to get that. Now, the other thing you can do for microphones is you can take the echo out of a room. Remove the echo. Now, I've removed the echo from this room. Hopefully you don't hear an echo. And the way I've removed it is on each of these walls right here, there's pads on the walls and these pads absorb sound. Okay. So that's kind of important, because this camera is a long ways from me. But if I want to use my cell phone, I can do that, but make sure I turn it horizontally. Okay. At least do that. And then I can use, I got a selfie stick down there. I could use a selfie stick to hold it in front of me, to hold it a little bit steadier, or position it on my desk so it doesn't wobble. Okay. So those are just a few of the things you can do to make your videos better without spending a lot of money on camera equipment. Now I have a nice Canon EOS, whatever, sitting in front of me now that my wife and I both use for YouTube videos. And I have a cordless lavalier microphone. I've got some lights set up around here. But the next thing is lights. Make sure you have good lights, okay? They gotta be able to see you. If you're in the dark shadows, you know, you're gonna look like a kidnapper or something. You don't want that, okay? You want something that it looks appealing to people. Number five, create some type of template. Now, what I mean by that is, you know, in the beginning of your video, like in the beginning of all my videos, I say what the title is because YouTube is listening to that title. And if I have the title written and I say it, then I have a better chance of that coming up in the search results. In addition to that, I'm gonna tell you, you know, what the video is about, because if it's not something you wanna watch, why would I keep you here? If it is something you wanna watch and you're interested in it, and I tell you about it in the beginning, you know, you're gonna go, oh, okay, I wanna learn that. I'll stick around, I'll listen to his video. So that's what I do. I ask people to subscribe and ring the bell, because if I don't do that, they won't. And then I won't get subscribers and I won't get bell ringers, and I need both of those, right? And then I get into the meat of the actual video. And this is kind of my template I'm going through with you. And then I ask them for comments at the end and give me a thumbs up. And that's pretty much every video I do is like that. And that's what you should have. Some type of template that you're going to follow each time you shoot a new video. Not to say you can't change your template, but start with some type of format that is the same throughout all your videos. Number six, learn to love analytics. Yeah, you want to get in there and you want to look at your analytics. And the reason you want to do this is because it will tell you which videos are doing good and which videos aren't doing good. The videos that are doing good, maybe you'll want to make another video or a follow-up video to that video on that particular subject, because that's what your audience is saying. Hey, I like that. I want more of that. We'll watch that. We'll like that. We'll comment on that. Maybe that's something you should do. Number seven, you're going to want to verify your channel as soon as you possibly can. It's really important to verify your channel so that you can use a lot of the features. I don't need to talk about that, but just make sure you verify your channel. And number eight, when you're setting up your channel, have a nice banner. Okay. Don't have a channel where the banner is just awful looking and there's nothing there and there's no place for them to click and no other links to anything. Spend a little bit of time on a banner. You can hire somebody at Fiverr. You can hire somebody at Upwork or Freelancer to make you a banner for probably 20, 30 bucks. Not a lot of money, but have a nice banner up there. Now, if you want to go to the next level, I recommend TubeBuddy. I have a link in the description down there. TubeBuddy helps you analyze, helps you find tags. It does so many things for you. I don't want to go through all that, but there is a link down there. You can get a free subscription to TubeBuddy. Free is cheap. And also, if you use my link and you decide to upgrade, you can get a 30% discount, which is pretty darn good. And it's inexpensive anyhow. It's just a few bucks, not a very expensive tool, but it will make you a lot of money. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you like what you heard. Now here it comes. Give me a thumbs up if you like the video. Don't forget to subscribe. Remember, I said I was going to ask you to. I need you to subscribe. If you haven't done it so far, turn that red subscribe button to gray. And as soon as you do, you're going to see a bell. Ring the bell. Turn on all bell notifications. That way, when I make a new video or I go live, I can notify you about it. You'll be part of the Fisher family, part of the VIP group that knows about all this stuff before anybody else. I thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Hey, thanks for watching my video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click that little bell right there so you can be notified every time I do a new video. Also, click on one of those videos there. Keep watching on my channel.